说的原因，就是因为小孩子也有一些受伤，我买了多少钱，他不少不行，我去找给他的病人，我给他找一些治疗的问题，我去找，我得找受伤，我得给，好像你自己生活做的。So all these people change without physical service for you. And I thought that you would want to make more of a situation. Share with them, that's right. That's right. Because that's what you said. And people come up with it with you. And you listen, thank you. That's what you are doing. And you're going to physical for you. The last is, if you go through it, you want to give more attention. In other words, if you want to say, the competition is 50% chance, you see the people, and you want to get 50% chance, you see the people, and you want to get 50% chance. So the other reason, that you actually think that you want to move that attention. But that's what it's like. This is how it works. Remember, all the people that you want to move that attention.Is a more considerate decision, superior to treatment control. This is something for ideas. So when we see no treatment, the other group of people, everyone being fit, in the drug, there's more people fit, people testicles. And all the people testicles produce significantly higher level of control. So, how much is the patient to achieve? It's a patient that is 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 a patientAlone, and they also want to study. And this is what you call surgeons, so that they also support the disease. There's another case study shows that one group intervention and the other group also in their screen, whatever center chain, doesn't have anything. Same by the name of them, it's better than in the intervention group. And just another people showing that at least they will be okay to send the human care is also terrible. One of the other group centers for treatment of back pain is people without stomach and the Asian cellular steroid. This is not because it's much instead that cellular steroid can compare with the single infection.So we can see some additional evidence about the use of infection drugs to achieve some achievement of acute and chronic group of pain. That is, however, in this case, we have reached by the journal and he concluded that after the five studies have failed, the more definitely can't serve some. And because the human cure is cured, some idea of the trauma will also be able to see in the next stopping, that reaches stopping trauma and individual injection and causes the fuel. So, this is people always have been dying, so which is pain management decision that comparing every human cure does not have to consider comparing with conventional pain and the positive.So in fact, this model of even discussion say that people control neural market problems because like the issue is medical, the dose of the system, 100 years ago was in China, China is not here, I call it only, you know you do such people, but also, you can't control whether you have to control in China, because everybody knows how to control the system, that's it's young. So, and so this is, you know, they have to study and consider more appropriate, rather than the explanation of how to use the people control. So our group around here, we can actually improve the system's quality of life. So the same issue of New England Journal, also in 1909, also in Stanford Group, shows that,And I'm aware that there are many effective studies comparing with robot and conventional care to show progress in the health system and the hospital. The robot is better.
様だけど。
are very far from natural. So they might be one individual. What it says is that it is it's really not natural for them to know the worst. And I think it's a potential over a degree of evolution. And it is also the sense of how it is literally never been possible. Maybe structures produce that
now, you mentioned that the other three of your colleagues are more on the side of faith. So, do you find guiding principles or ethical principles stemming from your faith that will sort of guide you or tell you what you should or you shouldn't do? Or how far you should go, how far you should go?
You know, I think what was interesting about, so sometimes we'll say something that doesn't suit the address, but we think what can be done, we'll say, wait, but in a way, there are some certain defines addresses. So, for example, there's a problem, it's likely to happen. Those people get a technology curve, you can observe, extrapolate. If you look at the historical precedence, you see that those technologies that have been banned, and most about those radical technologies have been banned somewhere or another, and the point is not going to be the link of time that sort of thing. So we're getting better at taking a safer adjustment.
Would that change anything that, chemistry, maybe talking about certain kinds of a compound, but in biology, especially synthetic biology, you're talking
choice here whether you want to get them at all, and then if you indemn them, whether you want to reimburse the inventor for the investment, or you want to encourage the inventor to continue to attempt to exchange any conversations. So I think that the increase on it is valuable to society, it's ethical, and it's just saves lives, and it reduces, and it increases the chance that species will survive, that it improves the quality of life, and they should be reimbursed and encouraged to do it again. So I think that the last thing, whatever they invented, should be reimbursed. Now, is there an ethical problem with the invention, with it's aimed at improving the quality of life?
If you pass, for example, the price of suffering that was meant to create living sentient organisms for more than dollars who are for cloning, right? And then you basically destroy them on death because they are your own property, you pay into their creation, you're God for them. You give birth to them, you grow them, and then you kill them to alleviate suffering, what you would call the real human beings. Would you be creating suffering at any time for those organisms?
Results are better, higher yields, better costs. Thank you.
They are not insiders, professors, and so forth. They are passionate because their family is like burned the soil and came all there to develop. Was an undergraduate when I was in my market course, and she went off on her own, in her apartment, and studied the genome, without company involved, any company, school, a kid's university, an MBA. And it was just so fascinating. And because she says the frequently asked question, it's called environmental, why we need genetics. And the fact is, the point of genetics is not to say, here's your genetic destiny, get used to it. It's really to say, what's the ideal environment for your genome? And it's all, and it's not one size fits all. And so in 1960, universities are still practiced on formula, for here in the United States, is this EKU, and all you have to do is avoid by theory, the amount you need to avoid your child from becoming intellectually disabled. So 100% environmental, and 100% genetics, not 50-50 really. Same thing for many cancer genes and preventative surgery. And while the genome project has been delivering its results, it's not a failure. There are now 2,000 such genetic tests. And these cannot be dismissed as being individually rare because they're collectively incredibly common, probably 10% is underestimate. Now, I listen to this suddenly, because of a million times cheaper cost, this is suddenly we're looking for rare alleles, individually rare and collectively common, and this is working really well. It's working much better than the very expensive studies that we did on common alleles. I'm very glad to hear. And so, for example, you can do 31 genomes or 30 parts of genomes, and you get out 25 new answers. And that's research. But the distance between research and the clinic is zero now. Here's an example of it. There are many others where the child had the first woman riddled with abscesses at the age of 3, already 107 surgeries. I think we would all agree that the diagnosis is not going well in this case. So in desperation, they sequenced the genome of this child and immediately saw what was wrong. Kind of like this. Because usually the seeing of what happens when you actually contact somebody, you see what's going on. And he changed from focusing on the abscess to the immune system from their implant. The kid was fixed in 3 weeks and still alive today. Here's an example experiment. This is really iconic. So we can now sequence individual genomes or individual cells in situ individual cells and find very rare cells, initially rare. Little green dots here are both are mutant in two ways. They're mutant in that they have a few cancer causing genes that have been mutated, and they have, in addition, a resistance to drugs like Revac and so on. And these green dots, because it's covered for Healy's group, indicate something where you really would like to detect the needle in the haystack. It's really possible, and it's very interesting. And highly personalized, it's not personalized. It differs between you and everybody else, but it differs from one cell to another in your body. So we're not going to be sequencing your genome once, but many, many times. And this would be part of constant monitoring. I hear your focal list, monitoring your heartbeat, let's monitor your genome and all the microbial components. So we don't go from a personal genome to traits directly. We have to think about environment. Environment is something we're very good at. In the personal genome project we have, this is one of the main things we do. We now have branches in the United States, Canada, and Korea. There are 16,000 volunteers so far, and for those who are listening to us. And for what we mean by environment, they can be the medical records now through Google Health are imported directly and put on the internet, and you can see them. And somebody wants to sequence a cohort of people that have a particular set of traits that they can prioritize those. And in red is what we consider environmental components, some of which actually have genomic components. And I don't really have time to go into all the data for this, but we are monitoring the microbial components of each of the volunteers from different body sites. And the immune response to it, where we can actually, again, because of this great decrease in cost, we can now sequence the entire immune response, not just at one time point, it's passed on, but in a time series, usually on the order of hours, days, weeks. In green is a trait, and if you trace the traits backwards, to some extent, there's detected genome, sometimes people mystify it. Really, it is just how all this interacts with your genome and environment plays out. And that is really where you trace how you develop from embryos and evolve, and how all your genes turn into your facial characteristics, your health, and so forth. That's the genome. It's not that serious, it's just a lot of work to sort it out. And part of that is the immune response, both an indicator of your environment, as well as just how you are very close to the person.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.